What is up, guys? It is Kikizilla 101 here yet again, and welcome back to Kiki and Coffee, the show where we casually talk about stuff and put in as minimal effort as possible while we drink coffee. So grab your coffee, tea, or other preferred beverage, and let's get straight into the video. Okay, sorry, I totally stumbled over myself there. Go check out part one of this video if you want to see my individual opinions and thoughts on each of these figures. I won't go into depth in this one. I wanted to make them a separate video so they wouldn't drag on too long. Now, I really want to share my opinions on this lineup here, and now I want to make it explicitly clear, guys. I am not hating on Safari. I love Safari. They are my favorite figure company that makes dinosaur models, and they really do listen to their fans. I really want to give them my feedback on this year and why I was really disappointed with this lineup at first. It's gotten a little better since I've seen, you know, some of the actual individual pictures, but I do think there's some stuff that I'd like to address and just give some feedback on so that Safari can take that into account and do with it as they wish. They always take a feedback in, and they always handle themselves really well with it. And I also like to hear your guys' thoughts on this thing too. When I first saw this, I had a mix of emotions and confusion, and I got on a negative look towards it, and I was disappointed. Now in hindsight, I know why when I first saw this, I was disappointed. First off, I'm gonna be bluntly honest here. Just bluntly, straight out honest. I think this was the worst Safari LTD reveal, at least that I've experienced. Now, that's not really that bad, because when you think about it, you know, they've done a pretty good job so far. So to be the worst isn't saying that terribly much. But I think it's the worst for one big reason. And that's that it showed everything at once. We got all of this at once. It was too much information. I was overwhelmed. I couldn't focus in on each one and really give them the attention they deserved, because as I started soaking them up over the hours and hours that I was talking to my friends about it, and today, my opinion started getting better on them even before I saw their individual pictures, and now it's even better on some of them. My first exposure to it was so bad because there's too much. There's too much going on. It's too much at once. It's really nice to see how many figures we're getting. It just overwhelms you with information. And then, to add on to the problem, it highlights the main flaws with this lineup as it is. Now, for one, I feel like this lineup is, it feels kind of empty, if I'm being honest. There's a couple reasons for that. It's very oversaturated with a certain body build. There's four theropods, which are long-legged bipedal dinosaurs with long tails that are counterbalancing their head and their torso. So that's the body build, the long tail, the head, the torso, balancing itself on two legs. The Pachycephalosaurus fits that. So you have the four theropods, you have the Pachycephalosaurus, and even the Edmontosaurus fits into that category. Even though it's a quadruped, the Hadrosaur still has that body type where it's got the longer legs and the counterbalancing head, and they can walk on by two legs. There's six figures that have a very similar body style. Then there's the Sarcosuchus and the Shringosaurus, which also are quadrupedal and in a very, very, very similar pose. The Ichthyosaurus is really the only one that's kind of different. So there's a lot of repetition in terms of body style, and it's also missing two things that Safari does every year as of recent: a ceratopsian and a sauropod. The lacking of those two definitely makes it feel like there's a hole in the lineup, because we always get the, and sure, you could say Pachycephalosaurus is, you know, somewhat related to ceratopsians and their primitive ancestors, but it's not a ceratopsian in its build and at all. There's no ceratopsian, there's no sauropod. That feels like a big empty shell there. Then there's the repetition of so many theropod body type style things going on here, which makes it kind of feel like there's a little bit of a lacking. Then you get into the fact that there's one color. Now, this is one thing I was mentioning about 2018 and 2019. Safari did great. They listened to our feedback. We wanted more colors. They gave us so many colors, all these popping, beautiful colors that were popping out everywhere. The Amargosaurus, the Anzu, you have the Styracosaurus. You have all these beautiful colors that are just popping out and just blessing you with this beauty. This year, you get this monotone of yellows, oranges, and brown. It's this warm, naturalistic yellow, orange, brown coloration that's consistent along every single model. Not a single one, not even the Ichthyosaurus, is able to escape this because it's got yellow eyes. So its yellow eyes are even in context with the rest of, there is at least a yellow, an orange, or a brown on every single model, and most of them have combinations of all of them. And that, when I first saw it, you know, made it feel almost like an elemental theme rather than like a complete line. Like a complete line to me would, like the other lineups, they have all these different variety and stuff, and this just felt like the you know, similar body shapes in combination with the similar colors, just, it just felt uninspired, and they were all just too similar and blah. Is the feeling it conveyed. Now, that's not necessarily true. They all have very unique qualities about them, and a lot of them are actually quite good on their own. But when you put them all together, your first reveal to them is all of them at once, and it's highlighting these core issues that they have. There's a lacking of variety of color, and there's a lacking of variety of body types, and a lacking of a couple body types that we get annually, and it's highlighted in this reveal image, and I think that shows the weakness. If they were all revealed like the other years where we got them one at a time, if we got pictures of them one at a time, I think that it would have been a lot longer before we realized, hey, like, I probably, when I made the thumbnail of this video with all of them in collage, or the thumbnail of the last video in collage, then I would have been like, oh, wait, there's a lot of repetition going on here. But since the reveal picture was, it made that very clear up front, and it made that first reaction more negative. Are you seeing what I'm saying there? Even though it's a really cool concept, just saying, hey, here's everything at once, I think it was too overwhelming. It was too much. It didn't give the figures a chance to stand on their own, and the format is a flaw, in my opinion. The way that it's revealing it this way, without the combination of the smaller, more high-definition images, even with how high-definition this shot is, the resolution is distributed amongst a lot of them, so you're gonna lose resolution on each of them, making them much harder to see the details on. So they're not even getting shown off in their best glory, or in their best form. And a lot of these angles aren't even the most flattering either, so just all in combination, it makes it hard to really see them for what they are, when you get them all like this, just in this one big explosion up front. And I think that is the one of the fundamental issues with this reveal, and why I was so disappointed in it. Like I've said, I've kind of bounced back on this because a little bit, just a little bit. The reveal, I don't think you can fix that. The reveal's already happened, so I still think it was easily their weakest reveal. However, I have warmed up to a lot of the figures individually, and I'm gonna get actually a lot more than I thought I was. Now, another issue that I do want to bring up, just one more issue that I have with this lineup, is their mouths. If you notice, every single animal in this lineup, except for the Chiansosaurus, has a closed mouth. And the only one with an open mouth, I don't really like that one too much, like the mouth, because it's got that tooth and lip issue thing I was talking about in the part one of this video. If you want to hear a little bit more about that, go in that one. Anybody who has been a safari collector knows that most of Safari's models actually have open mouths. And my philosophy on when you're making a model like this, and you're making one version of it, I think the best route to go is to go for you can go for a little bit dynamic, but you should try to be primarily neutral posed. You should try to make the most play value out of it possible, so that kids and collectors can enjoy it alike, and it allows them to do what they want with it, rather than limiting them too much with an extreme pose like other companies do. They'll sometimes put figures in two of an extreme pose that you can't enjoy it in every scenario. And so things like the Safari Allosaurus, you know, it's in somewhat of a neutral pose, and so it makes it easy for you to, you know, use it for whatever you want, but it's got a subtle sway to it. Leaving the mouth open, I think, is usually the better choice, because then you give the availability for them to choose what they want their animal to do. I think it's a lot harder for a kid to play with an animal with a closed mouth and make it look like it's eating or something. I don't really think, you know, many people are really too interested in closed mouth variants. Now, the Utyrannus figure from Safari was really interesting at the time because of it had a closed mouth, because everything had open mouths at the time. And it was a unique choice. But anybody who knows anything about sculpting, as a couple of my sculpting friends have told me, and just anybody that, you know, just thinks about it logically, it's way easier to sculpt closed mouths than it is to sculpt open mouths. It just kind of gives me a kind of a lazy vibe to the animal's mouth. I just I don't feel like it's really interesting. And even the closed mouths, I mean, sure, you can use the excuse of lips, you know, but a lot of the shape of the mouths are actually lost. I mean, I think the Deinonychus was a good choice with the mouth closed, and I think the Shringosaurus is fine, and the Pachycephalosaurus and Edmontosaurus aren't really super affected by that. The Sarcosuchus, Concavenator, and Dilo, those three I really feel like should have benefited from a open mouth, and they just don't have that. That's another thing that's kind of highlighted by having them all in one thing. That takes a little bit longer for you to notice, but once you do, you're like, wow, there's like nothing with open mouths here. Now, this might sound petty, but I mean, it's just my opinion. That's just how I'm taking it in, and I think a lot of other people are going to agree with me. I already know a lot of people agree with me based on some of the feedback I've seen and some of the people I've discussed this stuff with. I feel like this was a really disappointing reveal. I feel like it's one of the weaker of the recent years. It's not a bad year by any stretch of the imagination, but it does have some weakness to it, and I feel like the reveal made it worse, and it made even some of the good models in it look not as good because of the fact that the reveal was so overwhelming. It highlighted all of the weaknesses and the lack of diversity in this lineup. I hope that you guys can take this as my personal opinion and just me trying to share it and try to give feedback to Safari. Also just getting my opinion out there for you guys to tell me what your guys' thoughts are, but also to tell Safari, you know, like what my thoughts were, give my 2 cents, and hopefully they can do a better reveal next year. Hopefully that they can learn some stuff from this. Hopefully my feedback is useful. Hopefully it's taken respectfully. I'm not trying to disrespect anyone here. Safari is one of my favorite companies. They're one of my favorite companies, just period, but they're also my favorite dinosaur model company. And I've loved them since, you know, when I was really little kid, and I really would love to see them grow and improve like they have been for many years. This seems like a little bump in the road, but it's not. I'm very confident in Safari, and I'm sure that they're gonna bounce back from this. I hope that this is a helpful video. I hope you guys enjoyed it, and I want to thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll catch you guys in the next one. Bye-bye.